This is how you make restaurant-quality cheesy katsu.
Chicken breast, seasoned with salt, pepper, garlic powder, and paprika. Add mozzarella cheese and roll. In a bowl, add your flour, water, egg, salt, pepper, garlic powder, and paprika. Coat the chicken in the flour mixture.
And to make the coating extra crispy and juicy, I'm using Japanese-style breadcrumbs from Good Life. And deep fry until golden brown.
Shifted higher than the ceiling, and ooh-wee is the ultimate feeling. You got me lifted, feeling so gifted. Sugar, how you get so fly? Sugar, sugar, how you get so fly?
By far, my favorite dinner for two to make is the saucy shrimp scampi. It comes together in one pan and under 30 minutes. Start out with a fresh baguette, cut it into slices, and then we're gonna drizzle with some olive oil just like this. Pop in the oven to toast until beautifully golden, and when it comes out, we're gonna brush it with a garlic clove. Now for the shrimp, we're gonna butterfly it, and you can either leave the tail on or take it off, and then we're gonna coat it in all our spices. Over high heat, sear the shrimp until it has some beautiful color, take out of the pan, and then toast your garlic in some butter. Then we'll add the chicken broth, red pepper flakes, black pepper, lemon juice, parsley, and lots of parmesan. Add the shrimp back in, toss, and that's basically it. All that's left to do now is enjoy with the crispy bread.
With three potatoes, I can make these potato rings. They are crispy and delicious. Start by cutting 500 grams of peeled potatoes. Add enough water, 1 teaspoon of salt. In a large skillet, add 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter. Add 3 crushed garlic cloves, 1 medium onion chopped into small cubes. Add 150 milliliters of water, 2 tablespoons of wheat flour, and cook for 2 minutes. And once the potatoes have cooked through, transfer them to a large bowl and mash them until a smooth mixture forms. Then add the cream we made. Add parsley to taste. 50 grams of cornstarch. This is the right mix. After that, use 2 round dough cutters of different sizes to shape the rings. And once the oil is hot enough, add the potato rings. I'll also thank you for sharing this recipe. See you next recipe. Bye.
Oh, you look so sweet. What you working, palace? Look at your physique. Girl, you are a beauty. Well, I am a beast. They must have been tripping to have left me off a leash. I like it. You could be.
Let's make the viral Parmigiano roast potato. They are super easy to make and extremely...
Mamma mia.
First of all, mix some melted butter with olive oil, garlic, oregano, chili, salt, pepper, parsley and a lot of Parmigiano. Now, cut your potatoes into half, dip in some more Parmigiano and bake in the oven for 30 minutes or until it's super sexy.